सो हाई गाइज एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ PIB 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइज इन टूडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर न्यूज फ्रॉम द PIB विच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ESI सेक्शन ऑफ RBI ग्रेड बी अन्नाबाद। गाइज टूडे सेशन विल बी क्वाइट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द अदर सेशन बिकॉज वॉट वी विल डू इन टूडे सेशन इज दैट वी विल टेक दोज न्यूज फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल विच वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड टिल नाउ। नाउ व्हाई वी हैवंट डिस्कस्ड दोज न्यूज टिल नाउ बिकॉज दीज न्यूज are very short to discuss in the form of questions. These are only the one liners or the two liners. So in news ko questions ki form mein discuss karna is not possible. And why we are doing this, what is the objective behind doing this? Because in the previous exam of RBI grade B, we have seen that RBI has asked so many things that were according to us are not relevant, jo ki hamare hisab se relevant nahi tha. So कीपिंग इन माइंड द प्रीवियस एग्जाम ऑफ RBI ग्रेड बी, हम उन सभी चीजों को अब करेंगे जो हमें लगता है कि वो थोड़ा सा भी रेलेवेंट है। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन। बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन। एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अदर रेलेवेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द सेशन एंड द RBI ग्रेड बी कोर्सेज। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन। सो वेरी फर्स्ट न्यूज इज दैट foreign portfolio investment inflows in the year 2020-21. So guys, this financial year, the previous financial year 2020-21 has witnessed the strong FPI inflows in our country worth rupees 2,74,034 crores. 2,74,034 crores FPI investment was there in the previous financial year of 2020-21. Now this brings me to a question. Can you tell me what is the difference between FPI and FDI? Please write down in the comments, since you are preparing for RBI and you must have read the finance part. So you must know this, the answer of this question, what is the difference between FPI and FDI? And again, if you don't know the answer, you have to write down in the comments that, sir, we are not aware of this particular question. All right. Now moving ahead to the next news, which is about the growth forecast for India in the upcoming financial year, that is this ongoing financial year of financial year 2021-22. So guys, most of the agencies like IMF and World Bank has forecasted that the India's GDP growth will be more than 10%. Like recently, World Bank forecasted that India's GDP growth in the financial year 22 will be 10.1%, and IMF has forecasted it as 12.5%. And most of the other agencies also forecasted that India's GDP growth will be more than 10% in this financial year of 2022. Okay. एंड जो अलग अलग जीडीपी ग्रोथ के फॉरकास्टिंग होते हैं वो हमें अभी याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, दैट यू विल वो जो सारी चीजें हैं वो आपको एग्जाम से एक महीने पहले की याद करनी होती है, अभी सारी याद करने की जरूरत नहीं है। देन टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडियन रेलवे स्क्रैप सेल, नाउ यू विल से कि हम इंडियन रेलवे की स्क्रैप सेल के बारे में भी पढ़ेंगे, तो अगर आपने पिछला एग्जाम दिया है तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि किस तरीके के क्वेश्चन RBI ने पूछे थे। सो इंडियन रेलवे अचीव्स highest ever scrap sale in the previous financial year of 2021 2021. It earned rupees 4573 crore during the previous financial year through the scrap sale. All right, and this is 5.5% higher compared to rupees 4333 crores during the previous financial year of 2019-20. All right, then let's move ahead to another news, which is about the launch of homeopathic clinical case repository portal. So the Central Council for Research in Homeopathy, Ministry of Ayush ke andar aata hai wo, has launched the homeopathic clinical case repository portal. Now this portal, guys, will be a user platform for all the homeopathic stakeholders. This portal will provide them with the homeopathic clinical cases unko milega through this portal to all the stakeholders which are related to homeopathy, like researchers, the medical students, the homeopathic doctors and the clinicians. Okay, so this portal will be a user platform for getting homeopathical clinical cases to all the stakeholders related to homeopathy. Okay, moving ahead to next news. So ye news nahi hai, basically this is a fact ki UNGA ka jo resolution hai 64/292 is related to getting safe drinking water. You should remember this ki agar koi डेवलपमेंट से रिलेटेड कोई क्वेश्चन आता है आपके एग्जाम में, इफ देर इज एनी क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू डेवलपमेंट, where you are talking about the safe drinking water. So you can use this UNGA resolution 64/292, which provides for getting safe drinking water for all. Now next news is the Competition Commission of India approves the acquisition of 89.6% of equity shareholding of Gangavaram Port Limited by Adani Ports and Special Economic Zones Limited. So हमें पता है कि आज की डेट में देश में दो ही राजा हैं, अंबानी और अडानी. सो अडानी को एक और चीज के लिए सीसीआई ने अप्रूवल दे दिया है, 89.6% ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर होल्डिंग ऑफ गंगावरम पोर्ट लिमिटेड. सो यू नो व्हाट आई वांट टू से, अटल इनोवेशन मिशन अनाउंसेस पार्टनरशिप विद AICTE, ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन. दे विल अडॉप्ट अटल टिंकरिंग लैब्स. They will adopt Atal Tinkering Labs and they will empower and mentor the school student innovators across the country through AICTE Institution Innovation Council. So there is one council of AICTE which is known as Institution Innovation Council. Through these councils, the student innovators will be empowered and mentored by the AICTE. And for this, Atal Innovation Mission has partnered with AICTE. Right? An Atal Innovation Mission has also partnered with Dassault Systems Foundation to transform the future of education and research in India with their 3D technologies and virtual universe. Jo Dassault System Foundation ki 3D technology hai, uski madad se they will transform the education and research ecosystem in India, and for that they have partnered with Atal Innovation Mission, which is done by Niti Aayog. And there is one more collaboration that is being done by Atal Innovation Mission, that is with Bayer. This is to work towards healthcare and agricultural innovations. Now, what is this Bayer? It is, guys, a global enterprise with core competencies in the science fields of healthcare and nutrition. ये एक enterprise है जो कि healthcare और nutrition की field में काम करती है. And Atal Innovation Mission has collaborated with this organization to work towards healthcare and agricultural innovations in India. Moving ahead to the next news, Government of India launched world's first affordable and long lasting hygiene product, which is known as Durokia series. Now what is this Durokia series? What these products will do? So these will provide instant killing with prolonged protection against the wide range of germs including the coronavirus. Yes. So ye jo product hai Durokia series, and remember it has been developed by IIT Hyderabad researchers. IIT Hyderabad ke researchers ne isko develop kiya hai, and this will help in instant killing of various types of germs including coronavirus. And another news is that the Ministry of Tourism, now can you tell me who is the Minister of Tourism? Please write down in the comments. मैंने कई बार आप लोगों को बताया है, so Minister of Tourism बताना है आप लोगों को. Signs MOU with various online travel companies which are Cleartrip and EaseMyTrip to strengthen the hospitality and tourism industry. बहुत सारे के साथ किया है, but most of the important companies are Cleartrip and EaseMyTrip. Ministry of Tourism has signed MOU with these two to strengthen the hospitality and tourism industry in our country. And again, the Prime Minister has announced a free food grain supply under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. So in line with Prime Minister Modi's commitment to the poor, the Government of India has decided to allocate free of cost food grains at 5 kg per person per month to nearly 80 crore beneficiaries which are the beneficiaries of National Food Security Act of 2013. And remember, it is over and above the NFSA food grains that they will get in the next 2 months of May and June. Jo NFSA ke under unko food grains mil raha hai, uske alawa ye milega, alright? And there was a Tika Utsav that was observed from 11th April and 14th April ke beech mein isko manaya gaya tha. And this was to ensure maximum vaccination to the number of eligible people across the country. ये क्यों कहा गया था? ताकि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोगों को vaccinate किया जा सके across the country. And remember, why only these two dates, 11th April and 14th April? Because 11th April was the birthday of Jyoti Rao Phule. I hope you know about him, Jyoti Rao Phule. And 14th April, of course, was the birthday of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. And the last but not the least, Sputnik V vaccine is coming to India now. It has got approval from the Drugs Controller General of India for the emergency use, and it will be the third vaccine after Covishield and Covaxin which will be used for vaccinate Indian citizens. All right. So this was about this session, guys. I hope all the news are clear, and this way we have covered each and everything from the month of April 2021. And from the अब से हर मंथ हम यही करेंगे, जब पूरा मंथ खत्म हो जाएगा देन वी विल टेक दिस टाइप ऑफ न्यूज फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस मंथ्स। ऑलराइट, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग, मिलते हैं कल के सेशन में, गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस।